Hello and welcome to Let's Play Atlantic Fleet with the British again. Now we are in part 7, last time we played a very annoying battle versus two enemy cruisers and a destroyer. Now it's our turn to fight versus Admiral Hipper and Z-31, which is a pretty fearsome composition, honestly, also in very bad weather. So let's go and see how it goes. Okay, we are very close by. Ooh, they haven't opened fire, that's... Didn't they spot us? I don't care, but I'm not going to complain. Okay, let's start support. Like, all support. Target Admiral Hipper, he's in the lead. Wind is coming from the side. So we need to adjust for that, like so. Elevation 12.4, I'm going to trust it, because I don't have any other way to go. Open fire. Well, estimation was a little bit long. Next in line is Jamaica, which is also going to turn to port. Wind estimation tells us an elevation of 14.5. We need to compensate a lot for the wind with this one. Okay, let's do so. 14.6, okay, it's almost the same. This one is good! Wow, those were a lot of hits. Yeah, I'm happy with that. Meanwhile, Icarus is going to make smoke, go flank speed, move closer. Going to try to do a torpedo run. Okay, Hipper has been hit. He's opening fire. Only one shot. That means, yep, a star cell. Z-31 is moving in closer as well. Opening up. Hit on the tops on the rear side. Probably that means the aft radar got damaged. Let me check. No, we don't have any damage. That's good. Okay. Keeping our course. So last time we shot past, if I remember correctly. Yeah, we did. We need to reduce elevation by a lot. Probably around 10 or so. Adjust for the wind, which is still blowing from the side. Open up. Seems good. One hit, but we are almost on top of him. Jamaica got a lot of hits last turn, which is really good. So we are going to need to reduce our elevation. Like so. Adjust for the wind again. Open up. One hit in the tops. Probably that means a disabled radar. That's good. Icarus is going to keep on moving closer, producing smoke. Okay. Well, two hits amidships. Don't like that, but not a lot you can do. Z-31 also fighting. Okay, he's passed. Good. Any damage? Some AA has been kicked out. Okay, we are going to turn ever so slightly to port. Starboard, sorry. So last time we saw that 10 degrees, we were pretty much on target. We have moved closer, however. Going to reduce this to maybe 9.4. Open fire. Good salvo, that one. Jamaica keeps on moving. Last time we were well past. Just reduced the range to 13.1 or something like that. Adjust for the wind. This should be on target. Open up. No, we are a little past. Icarus producing smoke, coming in closer. Okay, Hipper is producing smoke. Yeah, he is. Yeah, that salvo was brutal. Z-31 is opening fire. I'm going to keep on tracking Hipper with Norfolk. but probably I'm going to start Suriname Z31 with Jamaica. Okay, last time we were on target. We are a little bit closer. We need to reduce our range. 0.3 should be enough. We are pretty much with the wind. I'm going to compensate, but not a lot. Open up. Well, yeah, that's kind of a very, very strong hit. Okay, Jamaica is here. We are going to switch targets with Jamaica. New target, Z31. Compensate for the wind. Elevation should be bigger by 2 to 3 degrees, I guess. I'm going to fire at 15.2 and we'll start adjusting from there. It's a good estimation, very close. Icarus is still going to produce smoke and coming closer. We might deliver a stick of torpedoes to finish off Hipper, we'll see. Z31, moving again. Seems a star cell, yep, it is. Okay, Norfolk is with the wind just behind. We are going to try to aim a little bit forward, try to hit the enemy on the turrets. He's moved definitely away. We are going to increase our target or range by 0.3 or so. Open fire. Yeah, some hits in the bows. Jamaica is going to shoot again. Last time we were pretty much on top. We are closer now. I'm going to reduce 0.2 or so and open up. We are on target. Two hits. Still producing smoke. Moving in closer. Good. Hey, Hipper has done a full 180 degree turn. Z31 misses. Okay, so Z31 is there in front of me. Was thinking about doing a starboard turn, but with this dude here I don't want to move closer, at least not yet. Okay, we have the wind coming slightly from our starboard. So I'm going to adjust the fire here and try to hit the aft turrets. Last time we were pretty much on target, we should be pretty much on target again. So open fire. And that worked. We got some hits in the area, no turrets knocked out it seems, however. Quite unfortunate. Okay, last time we were on target, we have moved a lot closer, so we need to account for that. Reduce elevation by maybe 0.7 or so. Open fire, a little bit past. Didn't reduce enough. Okay, Icarus is moving closer. Not sure of the range. We will check on later. Hipper is still producing smoke. Works for me. Z31 opening fire again. Have to be careful, really, really careful. I don't want this dude to fire torpedoes on me. Okay, so we are past the wind, we need to compensate for that. Last time we were pretty much on target, but he has moved away. Let's increase that to a little bit more, 9.9. So get some hits on him. Yeah, one in the aft area. Not enough, however, we need more hits. Last time we were well past, I'm going to reduce a lot. 18.1. Okay, we need to compensate a little bit less for the wind, that's okay. Let's keep on moving closer with Icarus. Yep, cut his route. Ooh! Okay, the boy is getting angry. Yeah, those hits won't do a lot, thankfully. That boy is getting angry indeed. Okay, okay, let's adjust. Last time we were just behind him, he has moved away. 10.9 degrees of fire, and see what we get. We get a lot of hits and some fires, which I'm happy to see. Last time we were a little bit close, this time we should be pretty much on target. Now we need to adjust for the wind, which is blowing. Yeah, last time we were overcompensating for that. Yeah, let's fire on this bearing. Two hits, rear side. Not sure if I really want to run the gauntlet, but we are going to keep on moving closer with Icarus. Gonna fight again, missing again. Z31, opening fire again, and some hits. The superstructure as well. Okay. Let's start with Norfolk. Keep tracking the enemy with all we have. Increase elevation a tiny little bit. 0.2 should be enough. Two hits. Jamaica is really taking his time to her time to finish the destroyer, to be honest. But that shouldn't take a long time. Last time we were pretty much on target, we have moved pretty much parallel. We are past the wind, so no need to compensate that much. Yeah, well, she took her time to find the range, but yeah, when she did, kind of worked out pretty nicely. Less producing smoke, moving in closer. Only one shot. Yeah, he's putting, I don't know what a star cell there will do, but hey, not complaining. Okay. Again, last time on target. We are moving more and more past the wind, so need to compensate for that. Increase elevation a tiny little bit, over enough, and see what we do. And we did a lot. Yep. Yeah. That was a pretty good hit. Okay, Jamaica's turn to open fire on Hipper again. We are pretty much with the wind. Let's adjust a tiny little bit. Yeah, around 14 should be more than enough. I'm going to reduce this to 14.6. Open up. Oh, wow. Those were a lot of hits. Okay, keep snaking a little bit while producing the smoke. Wow. Big hit. He's coming closer, however, and I don't really want this dude to be hit. Tiny destroyers don't get very well being hit by cruisers, as Z31 clearly shows. Okay, so we are already a little bit closer even, so I'm going to reduce elevation a bit. Open up. Get another massive explosion on him. We are doing a lot of damage, which I really hope it starts showing soon, of course, because this is no good if we can't sink him. Okay, we are pretty much on the same elevation. Yeah, we were. Even more smoke. Snake a little bit. To the wiggle, 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 wiggle. Only one shot, that seems. Yeah. A flare. I mean, we are really blasting the way at this dude. Okay, we were aiming here, getting hits around here. So if we aim here, we will start getting hits on the bows. We are a little bit closer, so I'm not going to change the elevation because I want to hit on the bow. And the bow is a little bit farther away from me. So that we did well. Same story here, let's aim there. We are at pretty much the same range. I mean, he's a sitting duck. That's one of the turrets destroyed. Produce smoke, wiggle the other way. And next turn we will lob some torpedoes his way and get the hell out of here. Ooh! Now he's shooting a Jamaica. Okay, that means that this is the moment we want to start lobbing torpedoes around him. Okay, so by shooting here, we got hits here. So let me take him here. We need to put this marker on the rear part and we will be getting hits on the rear of the enemy. And so we did. Don't know if we KO'd any of his turrets. No, we didn't. That was unfortunate. Okay. Same rule here, more or less. Let's aim. Oh, I have to move. Sorry. Wow, that hit really caused a lot of damage. Two fires. Okay, let's aim here. Pretty much the same range. Open up. And he's sinking. Mission accomplished. Medium damage on Norfolk and Jamaica, that's okay. Admiral Hyper sank, C31 sank. Quite a little bit of frosties, that's good. Continue. What's going to be our next battle? Our next battle is going to be up here. And Königsberg, Karlsruhe and Köln. Three cruisers. Decent weather, however. That means that I'm not going to be so much worried. I mean, there are three cruisers, but I don't think I want to invest on any new ships. We are at 40,000 renown. Okay, there were some questions in the comment sections about which ships do I want. Let's review. I really want to begin with, I want one battleship, obviously. Now, Queen Elizabeth. The Queen Elizabeth is a pretty good ship because it's reasonably quick. Reasonably, it's not fast, exactly. It's 24 knots maximum. But the problem is mostly the armor. 13 inch bed, 13 inch turret, 3.5 decks. Now, quite sadly, that's not enough. And that's not enough because, of course, versus cruisers, that's more than great. But the problem is that with whatever battleship I choose, I'm going to be fighting versus, I don't know, Bismarck, Tirpitz, San Host, and is now those big ships. And against those ships, 13 inch belts are not going to cut it. So, no. Of course, the problem is this is 62,000 renown. The revenge is 48,000 renown. Again, shares the same weakness. The belt and turret is not enough. The deck is not bad, but the other two are not. And it's only 21 knots top speed, which is really bad. So, not really looking forward one of these. Next is an interesting one, which is the Nelson. And this is one that I would probably go for. Reason being, it's not amazingly fast, but it's not a turtle either, at 23 knots. It's got 14 inch belts, which still aren't enough, 16 inch armor on the turrets, which is really good, 6 inches 25 deck, which is really good, but the most important part is it has 3 triple 16 inch turrets. So it's kind of, really can't take a lot of hits, but whatever you are hitting can't take a lot either. So this I might go for. 74,500 renown, however, midway there. And the one I really want is this one, King George V. Now, this has almost 15-inch belt, which is a lot. Turrets are not so well armored as the Nelson, but it's still decent. Deck is enough, 5 inches. Has 10 14-inch turrets, but the most important thing is something that doesn't come in the stats. I have fought this ship a lot in the German campaign and in the German Battle of the Atlantic. I have found the KGBs a lot of time. These things take a shitload of damage to go down. They really can take everything. So, for me, it's either Nelson or KGB. Of course, I need to save 35,000 renown for that. And I don't know how I'm going to do it. Because, for those of you who don't know, let's go back. Okay, let's get out of here and show the options. For those of you who don't know, I'm playing with everything switched on. At least in what regards to the campaign. For the Battle of the Atlantic, I don't have everything switched on. For the campaign, I have the longer static range, limited visibility, enemy ships can disengage, no enemy damage report, dude weapons, so some hits are going to be dudes, with affect player cells, so wind dispersion really is a big deal, elite enemy gunnery, and by god I can tell they are elite, shooting at me because they seem to have rangefinders, historical ships only, that means I don't get the lions, but I will probably be facing H-39s, which is going to be a serious deal, and the most important one is the 50% renown earned. That means that I'm getting only half as much renown as what is normal. That's to make the campaign a lot harder. So, yeah. What means is that I'm going to take at least 3 more battles before I can access the ships I want. Probably more, probably 4. So, yeah. And of course that, obviously that without buying anything new. We'll see if we can really win with these dudes. The 3 battles we need. Which is going to be questionable. Because probably we will need to deal with 2 heavy cruisers and a light cruiser, and with this composition of forces, I simply can't. I'm going to be destroyed. I mean, elite enemy gunnery really makes a huge difference. So, yeah, well. That's it for my future planning. Probably I will try to reach 75,000 renown without purchasing anything new to get a King George V or a Nelson. But if I'm forced to, I will have to settle for something smaller. Probably a Queen Elizabeth. We'll see. In the meantime, well, this is it for this chapter. I hope you enjoyed, thank you very much for watching, and see you others!